Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Prabhat Pandey. I bring with me a progressive years of experience of over 10 plus years in the IT industry, and I have been practicing Agile for quite some time now. And well, we have an upcoming event of Discuss Agile 2017 in Bengaluru, and I am proposing a talk on one of the themes called personal agility. Well, there's a very good saying by a very famous author, Zig Ziglar, that what you get by achieving your goals is not as important as what you become by achieving your goals. So we are all born with a fixed amount of time in our lifespan. And the best part is that on our planet, the entire animal and plant kingdom, they cannot have more than 24 hours in a day. However, we as human beings especially feel that we are the busiest of all of them. And we have so much to do in a handful of time. Hence, time becomes a very, very precious commodity for us. But with respect to personal agility, how about if we learn the art of time compounding? Now, it applies to our personal lives too, with respect to our professional lives. And what is it? What is this time compounding? So it's a science of actually creating more and more time with what you have in your hand by investing it very wisely. Now, people like you and me, we have 8 hours of time for our work, professional work. And obviously, each one of us, we need 7 to 8 hours of sleep. Now, balancing these 2 16 hours, what about the remaining 8 hours? What do we do in the remaining 8 hours is what matters the most. Okay. How do you invest your time? That determines your happiness, joy, and success. Now, we should be investing that time in activities that can pay us the highest returns, whether the returns are financial, psychological, spiritual, professional, anything for that matter. Okay. For example, personality development or our own skill development. Okay. So the returns we earn from these are of significant value, and we can yield better results in future. And then we can say that, yes, this particular month, I have done something of value on myself. Okay. Now, doesn't it really map to the agile patterns of delivering something of value at the end of iterations? I believe yes. Okay. Now, what personal agility has done for me, okay, what this framework has done for me, basically. First of all, it has helped me visualize my life. Okay. Now, let me try help you understand this, that the fact of the primary factor which distinguishes the entire animal kingdom from us is the ability to have vision. Okay. We all dream, be it night or day. But when we put a date to our dream, that's when it becomes a goal. And that's when I say that a dream without a goal is just a wish. Okay. Now, through this personal agility framework, okay, I started to understand how important it is to sit down and write our goals, okay, both short term and long term. Now, what is it that I want in life? What do I do to accomplish my goal? And what is something which is most precious to me? So I understood that I need to focus on a persistent and consistent manner on my goals to achieve it. And goals can be small to begin with, like paying an electricity bill. Okay, so that is something which is not a bad goal. Obviously, it can stay that way, or it may evolve into bigger goals, which is like evolving into features or epics. But obviously, the bigger the goal, the better plans we need, better strategy we need, just like it works in an agile framework typically. Now, the framework of personal agility, now this has helped me in pushing my dreams or my goals towards the finish line. Okay, and that's when I call it that my goals have actually reached the definition of done. Now, that has changed my perspective on life altogether. And through this, I can ensure that I'm not wasting my time, energy, or money in fulfilling something which I don't really care or I don't really bother about, which is something which doesn't really matter to me much. My parents have always taught me one thing, that there is a difference between a good life and a great life. Now, what is it that I want? Am I happy with a good life? Or can I stretch a little bit and move towards a great lifestyle? So, it all boils down to the fact that what is the definition of motivation? What motivates me to go towards the finish line? And I have understood that the definition of motivation through this framework is a very simple formula, which is needs times faith is equal to motivation. I'll repeat that. Needs multiplied by faith is equal to motivation. Now, we may wish to call them as our needs, our goals, our dreams. And I would like to quote an example here. If we show a biscuit to a dog, okay, it does some tricks, right? It jumps up and down to catch that biscuit. Now, the dog is not thinking at that point of time that if I'm going to do this particular trick, I'm going to have a dog house 5 years down the line. The dog is thinking that if I'm going to jump, I'm going to get that biscuit. Yes. So he's unable to prioritize. He's unable to reprioritize. And this is what is called a short-term mentality. Now, those dreams, those needs, that motivate people. Secondly, I'll be more motivated and agile if I have a faith in myself that, yes, I can achieve something. I can do something. So that faith on oneself is also very, very important. Now, since it's a multiplication factor, so if either my needs or my faith, it goes down to zero, my motivation, obviously, it will go down to zero. Okay. And it's imperative for us to have a track of our weekly goals. Look at our calendar slots, that what did I do last week to achieve my goal? Where do I stand today? What am I going to do tomorrow or the next week so that I can... And these are available in different applications, softwares like Trello or something, where I can actually keep a track of all these things and map it to the agile values and principles when I reach my definition of done. Okay, for individual short-term goals, maybe initially. Now, we can keep talking about multiple powers and different universal laws that govern, and we can implement the agile values and principles through those personal agility framework. But what matters to me most is something which is uncovering the blind spot. Okay. Now, this is something very, very important, and I would like to help you understand what is this uncovering the blind spot. Okay. And I typically call it a personality quadrant. Now, what is it? First of all, I draw a quadrant here. Now, in this quadrant, the first quadrant, it talks about something which I know about myself and others also know about me. For example, the color of my hair and the fact that I carry a mustache and beard. So, I know about that myself and other people also know about me. Secondly, something which I know about myself but other people do not know about me. For example, my bank balance, my payslips, okay, what's there in my PF account. So I know about myself, but others do not. Okay. Third quadrant is something which I do not know about myself, but others know about me. And this is very, very important, which is called a blind spot. Okay. And the fourth quadrant is something which I don't know about myself, and others also do not know about me. Okay. Now, I am more interested towards this lower half, okay, and how I can minimize this and how I can maximize it and bring it to the upper quadrant where I try to uncover my blind spots. Now, these are in this is where we actually need a mentor or a coach, an agile coach in agile framework. So when we see that, I personally believe that personal agility has brought in a lot of flavor to help me uncover my blind spots. The priority of them, there are two things. First of them is through communication and transparency, which is a very core principle of agile values and principles. Okay, power of spoken words, okay, self-talk. Do we have enough confidence on when to say no to others? Okay, how can we develop that? And second is individuals and interactions. Okay, very important. That is what I call power of association. It may start with your family, and you can develop it to extending it to your relatives, your friends, your customers, your suppliers, your stakeholders. Okay, now I'll take a few minutes to give a very small quick introduction on what is power of spoken words and what is a power of association. Through this, how personal agility framework actually fits in my life. Okay, first of all, power of spoken words. Now this is a self-talk to myself, okay, and it helps in reversing the negative programming which is present in my brain. For example, now, agile values and principles, they talk about this communication and transparency a lot, talking to people and teams. But in coherence, it all starts with self-talk, I must say. Because in the success vocabulary, we eliminate words like maybe, try, if I reach my goal. There is no if, there's only when. Okay? When I reach my goal. Okay? Now, speak the future in the present. And then you will have it. Okay. You can achieve it. Okay. For example, when are we most excited when we are watching a movie? Okay. It's when the lead actor, he actually quotes a statement which he is going to do in the future. And that's very powerful statement, and that motivates people. It's a positive statement. He hasn't done it yet. But nobody comes to us and say that, hey, you know what? Let's applaud. Let's applaud now. No, it is automatic. So that self-talk, that power of spoken words, because words are seeds, is very, very important. Secondly, power of association. Now that brings a complete mindset change. It's a mind shift and a permanent behavioral change. Because we as human beings, we associate with people. Okay, we cannot live without association. And this framework of personal agility says that we are the product of our environment. Okay? And we tell our children that be careful whom you hang around with. But at the same time, we forget that it is applicable to we adults too. Okay? How does somebody become alcoholic? Okay? He doesn't somebody invent alcohol out of the blue. No, they hang around with people who drink a lot, and that's how they become alcoholic. Okay? Now, by this same virtue, if I want to be financially free, I got to find out a way to hang around with people who are elite entrepreneurs who have been successful in life throughout. And then that is how the power of association works. Now, if I tell you, okay, the quality of one's life is governed by the average of the closest five friends they hang around with. Okay, and that happens always. So if we choose to excel in life, we just have to increase our association with right kind of people. Okay? And we need to figure out how this success circle sort of thing works. Okay? That is something which we discover from ourselves within. Okay? And with these two topics revolving around, I'm really excited to share some of my key experiences, my approaches, my successes, my failures, and in applying agile values and principles in the context of my life. Okay? And I'm sure that you will get to see and learn something unique from the proposed talk and a handful of takeaways back home. So looking forward to seeing all of you in the Discuss Agile conference. And till then, have a great day. Goodbye.